Hello, this is Erze Schimm from my standard flight field. Today I do some tests with the dive copter, with the drink copter as I call it, because it had this yaw tendency which is awful on dives. So I will just do some hopefully safe flights over the field and try if I can get it tuned out. Using 2.4 again and my old Fetchax with the huge image. Which is nice, which is really nice quality. And just having the small battery, so my flight time will be around 4 minutes. Okay. Now I switch to manual mode and it really looks good on the field. Just have to watch not to kill some berry collectors here. And I'm not gonna overstress this old battery here. Oh. I don't know how many times I flew here already, but the landscape is just so gorgeous. Awesome. So I see the city of Glocknitz now. Gonna gain some more height and try to provoke these yaw problems I had lately. Yeah. 10 minutes. So this is half my flight time. Gonna get some more alt. Still not using an OSD here, just want to keep it very very simple. So I tried this yaw thing and if I stop it immediately stops, so no yaw overshooting here. So do some dive. And no yaw either. Interesting. So do some speed. No problem whatsoever. I mean, it's good, but we'll have to see later. It's really good or not. It's really relaxing if you know your setup works. So with 2.4 I can even go behind trees a bit. Oh, my battery already beeps. But we have to continue these tree passes here. Don't we? Ah, now the image was really bad. Okay. Okay, I gotta come in. These batteries are really bad. These are 4000 milliamp Turnigy Nanotechs, but they are swollen up a bit. So I decided not to switch to auto level mode on the landing, because it was freaking out last time I used it. But it's really fine with manual mode now. Probably I shouldn't land on the table. Shouldn't try to land on the box either. And cut the throttle. Okay, fine. First flight, 5 minutes with the old battery. Too much, possibly. Gonna collect it. Second flight with, I have a bunch of 3300 milliamp 20 GE nanotechs. They are a bit better but less capacity, so switch to 330 minutes, and they will do fine for some test flights. Okay, altitude manual. Oh, altitude. Start in altitude. I prefer to really start quick, do a jump start, because if you hesitate on the start, you can really get into problems. Like the system turning into one direction and already killed the prop last time. I was so hesitative on the start. Oh, here we go. There's a biker. I can follow him for 1 or 2 minutes. He looks like a too slow target to follow. Don't think he even... Ah, no, he turned his head. It's always nice. Okay, you shouldn't fly so low and far out. Well, we're around 500 meters now. And I should be able to go past these trees. No video, okay. Okay. Hello, flyby over the nice field and the berries. I gotta Google Translate mice field. Some wheat and some mown down wheat, which makes it easier to find. And by the way, the command microphone now has a dead cat on it, so even with some gusts coming up now, you should hopefully have a fine audio. So just enough time to check out this huge ball. Hopefully don't scare the berry collectors. So it's some sort of gas tank, I guess. Probably don't want to crash into it. Okay. And come on, easy over. Oh, here's one. No, it's bush. So 330, we should be good for some low passes. Doing some speed up. If you turn back, you can really hit the brakes. Yeah. Since I have three other of these batteries, I will land now and check the voltage. Maybe these are also fine for 4 minutes. Because it's really enjoyable right now. Okay, fine. Gonna give some throttle here. See where we get. Of course we get high. Yeah, now I wanna do a dive yaw problem test again. So I gotta gain some altitude. Not flying 100% throttle, by the way. Just wanna calm the batteries, or don't wanna waste the batteries. So as you see, I changed the yaw pit settings, and it's really responsive. And if I stop, it stops. That's what it should do. Okay, so we're far and high enough. Doing the turn and the down, and yeah, it's really nice now. One thing possibly, I already said this, maybe the big batteries and the additional tail weight do something for... the yaw problem. Okay, so if I do some crazy turns, I should be over safe crash ground. Not over the roads. And not over the berry collectors either. No, fuck. So if I go like tail heavy and turn. No. Looks like I can't provoke it now. If I stop, it stops like it should. Ooh, this sounds mean. I guess I scare them anyways. Fuck. Okay. Got a descent in the woods. Oh, I scared a bird. Okay. Oh, damn. 1 minute. Shouldn't bother the neighborhood here. The birds and the trees are fine with me, and good thing about the birds, they don't call the police. Oh, there's a river, a small river down there. Like it. I'm at the edge of my patch. I always love these bushes and trees here in the middle. They look funny. Ah, now I have beeps. So we gotta choose the route between the trees. And next to the chocolate factory. I hear some awful multipassing because of the reflections of the... Oh, it's not bad today. Okay. Yeah, really confident now with the braking, so it's feeling really, really nice.
Engine off.
Wow, nice. Yeah, you gotta love this. So that's my ground station for today, this nice table. We got a nice secure flight field nowadays. Because so many of you complained about the big copter flying so close to people. So now we have an air. This is my 2-4 ground station with the Hobby King DVR and 2.4 Q planar wheel from Circular Wireless and the Helix from Circular Wireless and the yellow jacket diversity receiver behind the antenna. It's really a sleek minimum space design for the ground station here. And as you can see, I pointed it up this hill. which means I want to, for the last battery, I want to fly up there and then dive down the woody hill and come on over to the flight field again. Okay, so this is the lovely hill. It's the Jungberg, the Young Mountain, and it is, oh, there are some cows there, and it's the Silversberg next, but you see a road down there, and I know the way up can be driven with the car. Okay, I don't have so much time, so we turn around, hopefully have no yaw issue, and gonna dive down, not a steep dive, but a lovely one with trees. Oh, always keep in mind not to lose our left line of sight. Wow, this has gotta look awesome. Having 1 minute and choosing my final approach here over this lovely chocolate factory building. Every time you hear the ground station beep, the diversity receiver decides to take another antenna. So at close ranges he's uncertain which antenna to take, to use, but he really does a good job most of the times. And then this darn alarm wakes you up. But it's safety is number one priority. So the Trinkopter really performed nice. Hope I figured out the yaw issue now. So thanks for watching this training episode. Bye.